breath I've taken from the streets of the Bronx to this moment on Hollywood Boulevard. And this all feels, I don't know, kind of surreal. I just wanted to be good at what I did. I wanted to be a great actress. I wanted to be a great singer. I wanted to be a great performer to share the joy of entertaining you.
This is Hollywood, with the mecca of entertainment around the world. It all starts right here. This is what it all comes down to. It all comes down to your family and working hard to love and protect and do everything that you can to make your family and the ones you love their lives better.
It's thrilling to have Anna Mae Wong, the first Asian American actress, as my neighbor. We could actually start our own little Chinatown right here.
I think about what a star is, and I think about a star being liked for so many people. A star you can always see, even in darkness. So my hope is that anyone in this town whose dreams may be on life support, I want you to walk past this star in particular and know that I've been there. This one in particular is for the underdogs.
It's an incredible day. I'm trying to soak it all in. Here's the thing about these Hollywood stars. They're permanent. What is a legacy? It's planting seeds in a garden you never get to see. Well, we get to see this star every day on the corner of Hollywood and Argyle.
Lo único que les puedo decir es que siempre recuerden que trabajando mucho, sin descansar y respetándose uno mismo y respetando a los demás, se pueden lograr cosas que uno nunca se soñó. Gracias a todos mis fans por estar aquí y un beso a Colombia y a todos los colombianos que están aquí. Gracias por venir.
I feel like a lot of people probably only ever thought I'd make it to the Walk of Shame, but here I am. Today for me is a celebration of something that my dad taught me. And that is, to thine own self be true. And if you walk along this boulevard and you look at these names, there is a power that lies in that. There's a power in believing in yourself.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. I am David Jerome, the president and CEO of the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce. And on behalf of the Chamber of Commerce, let me welcome you all today to our Walk of Fame ceremony. The Chamber is all about, it exists basically for business transformation and improving lives, but today, we are celebrating a business that actually transforms our lives. That's show business. Show business brings together business and art in a way that surprises, delights, and also enriches us in ways that I think we're here to celebrate. I cannot think of any better way to do that than putting a star on the Walk of Fame. But before we get on with that, let me just take a moment to thank all our viewers that are online today and Variety for making that happen. We're very appreciative. I also want to take a moment, if I could, without further ado, to welcome our MC for today, the incredibly talented Mr. Vic DeBone. I think you know him. I think you know him as a writer, as a TV producer, and without further ado, I'm going to hand the mic over to him. Thank you.
Vin, thank you.
Thank you, David, and welcome to Blue Attire Day here on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. It's also the day that we honor Laura Linney. She'll be receiving the 2000 727th star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame in the category of television. Before I invite her up on the stage, let me tell you a little bit about our honoree. Laura was born in Manhattan, New York. Her mother was a nurse at the Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center, and her father was a playwright and professor. Laura spent summers with her father in New Hampshire and fell in love with the stage, working with local theater groups beginning at the age of 11. She graduated from Brown in 1986 and went on to study acting at the Juilliard School. She also received an honorary doctorate of fine arts degree from Brown. Listen to the film credits: Nocturnal Animals, Sully, Kinsey, The Savages, Hyde Park on the Hudson, The Squid and the Whale, Mystic River, The Truman Story, Love Actually, among others. She will soon be seen in the Miracle Club, where she's set to star opposite Maggie Smith and Kathy Bates. In TV, Laura can most recently be seen in all four seasons of Ozark, the critically acclaimed network original series, where she plays Wendy Bird. Boy, did she play Wendy Bird. And on that note, we've placed Laura's star right near that of her Ozark husband, Jason Bateman, just behind me. Laura also starred in and served in as executive producer for the Showtime series, The Big C, for four seasons. She also won multiple awards for her portrayal of Abigail Adams in the HBO miniseries, John Adams. In June 2018, Laura made her London theater debut in Richard Eyre's limited three-week run of My Name is Lucy Barton. She has also appeared in many Broadway productions, most notably The Little Foxes, Time Stands Still, and Sight Unseen. Throughout her career, Laura has won four Emmy Awards, two Golden Globes, five Tony Awards, among others. She also holds two honorary doctorates from her alma maters, Brown University and the Juilliard School. So without further ado, let's welcome to the stage Laura Linney. Before we hear from Laura, there are two guest speakers here to say a few words about our honoree. Our first speaker is Emmy-winning and Tony-nominated actress and playwright who's been a regular fixture of stage, screen, and over five decades. She has received eight Emmy nominations during her career, notably for The Practice, Two and a Half Men, and most recently for Ryan Murphy's Hollywood. Currently, she appears on television in The Morning Show and also on The Chair. On stage, her nine-year history of performing in her Tony-nominated play, Anne, culminated this spring with her final sold-out run at the Pasadena Playhouse. Please welcome to the stage, Holland Taylor.
Had I known he was going to read that chunk of bio, I'd have slit my throat on the way here. Laura Linney is an adored fixture in my life and has been for about 30 years. So collecting my thoughts about her is like trying to pack everything I love from all my closets into a smart little overnight bag. And scanning her enormous, really shockingly vast list of important titles in film, TV, and stage, not to mention an honestly embarrassing collection of awards, honors, and nominations. Yes, miss, you should blush. I mean, it's like over 100. 100, really? I mean, was that necessary? It makes me think, good Lord, this woman is a goddess from Olympus. And I have allowed our long, cozy friendship to keep me from being fully aware of her enormous achievements. In fact, looking over her work, just the sheer numbers, I discover I've actually not seen a few of these. Actually, more than a few. And it's a testament to our insane modern life, of course, but also, girl, if you were going to make that many movies and TV shows, you know, you're going to lose a few of us who have to live our lives and do our work making our own little filmographies. So give us a break. Now let's look at the dark side, shall we? Don't you think there were casualties along the way to Olympus? Diva doings and betrayals behind her pristine blonde goddess image? Come on, she can't be that good. Knowing her for so long, I could for sure tell you that maybe you don't want to meet her in a dark alley. Maybe there are a few bodies left in a ditch after quite a few of her movies and all those former close associates who dare not speak her name. I'd love to be the one that blows her cover. But as Richard Nixon said so many years ago, that would be wrong. I'm sorry, but scratch Laura Linney and you find, God help us, Laura Linney. Almost 25 years ago, while shooting The Truman Show, the fairy tale seaside town in Florida, Laura had taken a house. And at an early rehearsal, knowing I was stuck in some Radisson whatever, she impulsively said, come stay in my house. It's huge and airy. I was so startled, I didn't know how to respond, except to say, gee, okay. So we hung out over the weeks, and I realized at some point that she was a gift in my life. Laura's generosity is like throwing money off the back of trains, full of air and sunlight. As with my stay under her roof, her gifts are given so lightly, you hardly know whatever has blessed you. Listening to a friend's troubles, Laura is at her most generous, really to a fault, giving you that laser intelligence and that warm heart, with never a flicker of impatience, with never a sense that, you know, she has stuff that she'd like to be doing. She is generous with herself, her time, that thing most of us keep tight in our pockets. She is, even during the pandemic years, when Laura was flying back and forth every single week between work in Atlanta and her son and husband in Brooklyn, all that time, it was she who called me every so often for a long FaceTime visit, a check-in during an era that was hard on everyone. Always the insanely busy Laura who thought to make the call. This kind of matchless friendship that presents no bill, this is a rare thing in life. Those perfect, clear blue eyes that invite you to be real with her. This is Laura. And as for the actress, I have a sudden insight. In all her shows and movies, curiously, Laura looks very much as she does in life, mostly quite contemporary. Very few roles required her to change anything about how she looks, you know, her, how she speaks, how she wears her hair. I can't offhand remember accents that she's had to use. Up on screen, at first glance, she just seems like Laura Linney. But equally curiously and to the point, when I am in her audience, lost in whatever performance she is giving, I can't see Laura at all. I don't see Laura Linney. I see who she is playing. She has captured me in plain sight, exactly as her generosity does, a kind of sleight of hand. I hardly notice that I have been shanghaied, and I am on the pirate ship Laura, on the voyage that she is sailing. Soon she will dump me back on the rude sidewalk, popcorn spilling from my lap, not knowing how I got there. This is the secret gift of Laura, Laura Leggett Linney, who is all that she seems. No smoke, no mirrors. just magic.
That's a pretty good friendship. Before I introduce our second speaker, we have a few VIPs in the crowd today supporting Laura. Please acknowledge Gene Triplehorn. Matthew Brumlow. Cora Vanderbrook. Jason Butler Harner and Leland Orser. We also have a few chamber VIPs in the audience, board members Matt Fritch and Kathleen Rawson. Our second guest speaker has spent 11 years as senior writer and contributing editor at Rolling Stone magazine before transitioning to television. Since working in television, he has written for such shows as Criminal Minds, Hell on Wheels, and Bloodline. In addition, he created and executive produced Criminal Minds Suspect Behavior, starring Forrest Whitaker, as well as AMC's Low Winter Sun. Most recently, he served as writer and showrunner for the hit Netflix original series, Ozark, for which he recently garnered 13 Primetime Emmy nominations for its final season, including Outstanding Drama Series and Outstanding Writing for a Drama Series. Please welcome to the stage, Chris Mundy.
I don't know whose idea it was to have the writer follow Holland Taylor. That's, keep in mind that I usually write stuff and then like Laura gets to say it, so be kind. When I was thinking about this and what I could possibly say, what I realized is I've never known anyone who does this job who did it less for the reason of getting a star on the Walk of Fame. So it makes it all the more perfect because this is literally just about the work. And Laura pushes and pushes at the boundaries of the art all the time. Case in point, after season one of Ozark, she decided to do The Little Foxes on Broadway, and she would switch roles every night. And I remember at the time when she was considering doing it, I'm like, well, why would you do it? And she said, well, because it's the scariest thing I can think of. And so she did it. But after season two, she realized that there was something that was more terrifying than that. And she decided to do My Name is Lucy Barton, where she was the only person on stage. So there was literally no safety net if she got lost or she screwed up. By the way, she never got lost or screwed up, which is probably not a surprise to anyone that's here. So in a strange way, I feel like this is the next scary thing because she has to sit here and like have people laud her. Laura taught me this idea that when you're creating something, whether writing or in acting, that there's just a period where you have to sit in discomfort. And I think about it all the time. We used to talk about it when trying to like write the show or acting. And I kind of think of this as what she's doing now, which is sitting in discomfort. But I've never met anyone truly in work or life that elevates the people around her more than Laura does. In the work, just with generosity and dedication, but more importantly, in friendships, everyone's life is better for having Laura in it. And I know so many different people that use her as kind of a compass of what the right way to behave or consider in a situation. And to be that for such a diverse group of people is truly phenomenal. So I know if she could that she would take her name off this and she'd fill it in with all the characters she's played on stage and on television and in films, but it'd take the block. So I just want to say that I'm incredibly happy that it's there, and I'm incredibly happy that it's permanent, and she gets to face it and look at it and realize that it's only there because of her work. So.
Laura, the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce administers the Walk of Fame on behalf of the City of Los Angeles. On behalf of the Los Angeles City Councilman Mitch O'Farrell, I'd like to present to you with a beautiful resolution from the city. On behalf of the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce, we now declare today Laura Linney Day in Hollywood. It's now time to hear from our honoree, the amazing, masterful Laura Linney.
Oh my goodness gracious. I had a feeling this would be a wonderfully thrilling, challenging day, but that going through listening to Chris and to Dear Holland and having all my nearest and dearest here is really, it's even more overwhelming than I thought it would be. I want to thank all of you for being here today, the photographers, the people who set up the tents, the people in the chairs, the people across the streets, and especially to the Chamber of Commerce for making this day possible. If someone had told me 20 years ago that this camera-shy theater person would be represented amongst her idols of film and television, I would never have believed it. I would simply have deemed it absolute crazy talk, it would have been ludicrous, and it would have sounded to me as puzzling and indecipherable as Charlie Brown's teacher. And I can honestly tell you that even after 30 years, I am still, on a daily basis, quietly stunned and not so quietly exhilarated to be embraced by not only by Los Angeles itself, but by the industries, the businesses, and the people here that I love that call this place home. My time spent filming and on sets in and among inspiring actors and filmmakers has been one of the great, surprising, enriching joys of my life. And to have... Oh boy. Oh yeah, it's, you know, it's where we are. I hope he's okay. To have my name held and protected by a star on this famous stretch of sidewalk is beyond my wildest dreams. But, is he okay? Is he all right? Just want to make sure he's okay. Okay. Oh dear. It's a difficult world we're living in these days. Things like this are intersecting everywhere. So on this day, if there is a day, please, I mean, since it is Laura Linney Day, I hope that we can all keep a little compassion in our hearts and educate ourselves about the needs of others and mental illness and addiction and everything that is being put in front of us on a daily basis. So as I was saying, to have my name held and protected by a star on this famous stretch of sidewalk is beyond my wildest dreams. But as thrilling as this all is, the ultimate reward, of course, is always the work itself. It's the invitation and the time given, hopefully by like-minded people,
to do the often unglamorous, yet exciting, challenging, necessary task of telling stories that deepen our connection to ourselves and to our fellow humans. The work, hopefully, not only enhances our perceptions of each other in both modest and even significant ways, but it can also visually or emotionally expose viewers to the previously unseen or unfelt. It can introduce us all to parts of ourselves that we had no idea existed. So in a time where our world is so challenging, when so much is confusing and chaotic and upsetting, it is the one tenet that holds firm to me, especially during this unstable time, that the arts are medicinal, clarifying, nourishing endeavor, and it is a wonderful thing to be in service to. Much in today's world is a waste of time. We squander what is valuable, but you can't go wrong with time spent with and around the arts. Regardless of your profession or your belief system, the arts are just good for you, for your family, for your community at large. They make everyone and everything better. That is a truth that I hold dear. What my film and television life has also given me is all of you. Whether we have worked together closely or we have never met, I can never thank you all enough. My closest friends, yes, Jean, Tony, Leland, August, Megan, where are you? Megan, Cora, and Matt, thank you for being here today. My remarkable colleagues, there are far too many to name, but that includes you, Chris Mundy, and you, marvelous, wonderful Holland Taylor, who you have both given me so much. Your friendship means so much to me, and it means the world to me that you are here. I know it's, you know, there are other things you all would rather be doing, so thank you. And that is you, my dedicated team, Tony Howard, Brian Mann, Aline Kashishian, Scott Wexler, Kevin Yorn, Jen Plant, and Michael Growler. And that is my beloved Ozark family, including the guy whose name is on the star behind me, and Patrick Markey, Alexa Fogel, everyone at Netflix. Bella, thank you for being here, and especially everyone at MRC, including Modi and Elise. Thank you so much for making, you know, all of you, a difficult last year of filming bearable and enjoyable and keeping us safe. Thank you. Thank you to the students, the faculty, and the administration of the Juilliard School for your continued inspiration, and to my extended family down south, and to the Linneys in New York City, and to James and Rachel. I'm so glad you're here. And especially to my stepfather, who I think would have been especially chuffed by this, and to my beautiful mother, my unbelievable aunt. Thank you both so much for your undying love and your humor and your support and for challenging me. But I would really like to end by sending my thanks and my deep love to my son and to my husband and to the entire Shower family, especially acknowledging my father-in-law, Peter Shower. They have all encouraged this introvert to live large, to love with abandon, arms open and outstretched, to hug long and hard, to laugh full-throated, and to fight with full lungs, and speak up and talk loud, to embrace all the good we can, to create it together with spirit and power and a life-embracing gusto. I wish all of this for all of you as well. So thank you so much for this amazing day. I will never forget it, and hooray for Hollywood.
So, Laura, if you have nothing else to do right now, be a good time to unveil your star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame.
welcome Laura Linney to the Hollywood Walk of Fame.
Touch the star.
It's yours.
No, no. About standing, guys? You want to stand?
Please.
Ladies together.
I want a jean.
Yeah.